We'll drink horse bar good beer and sit on your backstays in a whispering.
Welcome back to episode 2 of Life in the Forest with me, Katherine, from the Vermont Land Trust. If you were not here with us last week, I will just remind you of what we're doing here in these videos. So, my name is Katherine. Like I said, I am the Education and Outreach Coordinator here at Vermont Land Trust. I serve with AmeriCorps, which is a service organization in America, hence AmeriCorps. And my work here is mostly centered around bringing fun, informative programming, place-based, you know, outdoor, environmental, educational stuff about Vermont and the natural beauty of Vermont. And today that natural beauty is light snow. And today we are again at Bluffside Farm. There's the barn. Bluffside Farm is a property that the Land Trust maintains and uses as office space. It's where I kind of have like an outdoor classroom type situation. And of course, class cannot be in person right now, which is, as I've said before, big bummer. But we're making the best of it, and I'm making these videos to teach you more about Bluffside and teach you about the forest that you might have where you live, either in Vermont or maybe in other places too. You know, I'm just thinking about the episode from last week and how we were doing parts of the forest, and I was coming out here today to enjoy the forest, and it's like snowing and it's kind of cold for end of April. Fun fact, I'm from Georgia, and I'll just tell you this much, it really doesn't snow that much in Georgia, especially not towards the end of April. So I come out here, I still want to enjoy the outdoors, but when I come out in the snow, I gotta put on lots of layers. You can see I have on the sweatshirt, shout out AmeriCorps, have on a little rain jacket. Underneath my sweatshirt, I have on a fleece, and then my base layer is a long sleeve shirt. I'm wearing jeans, wearing fluffy socks and boots. Got a hat on, my neck warmers in my pocket in case I need it. And don't have gloves though. My hands are cold, thank you for asking. I'll be okay though. Anyways, I'm walking through the forest and I'm thinking last week when I showed you the forest, it was kind of cold, but not this cold. But the trees don't have any layers that I can see. They don't have any rain jackets. They don't have gloves. They do not have hats on. And I'm talking to some smart kids at home. You guys know this. You know that trees do not put on winter gear. And I'm wondering, how are these trees staying warm in the weather if they don't have, you know, they don't put on extra layers of clothing? But I'm wondering, what do they have that keeps them warm? What do they have that acts like a jacket protecting them from the outside world, from the weather? What do they have that helps them move the food from their bodies? Because they can't quite grab a granola bar from the kitchen counter, can they? And eat it and move it into their bellies. Do trees have bellies? So I have these questions. Maybe you have them too. Maybe you already kind of have ideas for what those answers might be, or for thoughts on what might be helping trees survive, even though they are standing still, never moving from their spot where they've started to grow. So let's explore together today. While you watch and listen, you can take notes, you can color, you can doodle. And remember that there are guided reflection printouts with every episode. You can print them out at home or copy them onto your own paper. So we just came up with some questions like, how do trees stay warm and protected? And how do they get their nutrients and their food? And normally I would try to explore these questions outside with real trees, but since the weather was kind of bad and I don't have a chainsaw to open a tree with, I thought I'd show you a creative way that I like to use to explore the parts of a tree. So I'll show you. So this is Tree Anatomy 101, and what I've done is taken some butcher paper and some pieces of sparkling water containers, the cardboard, and I have made the parts of a tree. And you can do this at home. It's really easy with whatever supplies that you have, paper, paint, markers, tape, and I'll show you the parts of a tree. So the middle layer we'll start out with, it's the red right here. Part of the tree is called the heartwood. You can think of it because it's at the heart of the tree, the heartwood. And it is the supportive part of the tree. It is dead, but it's not decayed. And like I said, it's in the very middle, in the center, so you can think of it as like the heart of the tree. And then going out, these blue layers, those signify the sapwood. So the sapwood is newer wood. It is where this thing called the xylem is located. And the xylem helps water flow up into the tree so that it stays nice and hydrated. And the cool thing about sapwood, the blue part, is that when it's older, it turns into heartwood once more sapwood has been made. And of course, if you open up a tree, you won't see these rainbow colors. But these are just to demonstrate to you the different layers. Next, we have the cambium. And the cambium is the layer of the trees that is growing, and it is making new cells in response to these things called auxins. That's the word auxins right there. Auxins are hormones, and when the tree sends out auxins, that means that it's time to make new cells. Next we have the inner bark, and that's where a thing called phloem is located. And the inner bark and the phloem help pass food down through the tree. So pass the food down through the tree. And then we have the outer bark, which is signified by this black layer, and that's kind of the protecting part. It helps to maintain the moisture of the tree, and it helps to protect it against weather and things like maybe animals or bugs. And it also helps to keep the tree warm, so it's like wearing that nice puffy coat or jacket. And then we have the crown of the tree, which, if you think of a crown that someone royal would wear, it's at the top, like it's on their head, and that's where the leaves are located. You can see my paper leaves here that I've made. And the leaves help to make food for the plant through the tree, through photosynthesis. And the tree uses it throughout its whole body. And then the very last thing, I'm sure you might be wondering, or you've probably been guessing, what are these things down here? They are the roots. So the roots help to keep the tree in place. They help to get water and bring the water into the rest of the tree. Keep the tree rooted. So you can make one of these at home and use it to test your knowledge of the parts of the tree anatomy. I hope you guys liked my fun at-home craft that can also help you be creative and learn more about the parts of the tree and help you remember them probably. But now I'm going to show you something cool with a real tree. So this is called a tree cookie. Nope, not the kind of cookie that you eat. It's just a slice of a tree right down through. And these are really helpful because you can see a lot of the things that we just talked about. And then I also have this part of a tree with some of the bark cut away so we can look on the inside. And again, it won't be as obvious as a rainbow colored drawing, but it's still cool. So I'm not a tree cookie expert, but I think this in the middle here is the heartwood. You can see it's a different color than the rest. And these rings are kind of the growth rings. So the sapwood, maybe that's part of the sapwood and the cambium where it's growing. And then you can really see the bark up close. And we'll look at the other tree trunk. So it looks like an average log. But we can peel back, we can peel back this and we can see the moisture in the tree. If you look really closely, I'm feeling it and it feels kind of wet. There's definitely moisture in there. And I wish you could be here to see it with me, but here is definitely easier. Oops, I'm not even pointing at it. Here is definitely easier to see how the outer bark and the inner bark are different. And yeah, so this is just a really cool way to try to tell apart the different parts of a tree. It's kind of hard to tell perfectly, but it's cool to apply what we learned to this. This is a photo of my favorite birch tree, and this is a photo of an older one next to it, and I just wanted to show them to you so that you could see the difference in the bark and the bark layers and the tree layers between the older and newer tree. Feel free to pause the video here if you want to take a closer look. So I hope you learned a little bit more about trees today. And why they are so special and so strong. Come back next week and we will learn about some specific trees that you might find in Vermont. And in the meantime, you can check out the guided reflection and you can look at the end of this video for the terms that we went over today. And you can have a great day and give a tree some love today or this week. This week was Earth Day. Bye.
We'll drink horse by the bay and sit on your back stairs in a whispering. Swear.